Hello everybody, in this video I'm going to talk about factors that can influence a project and how to face with them and how to manage them and how to get success in projects. When we talk about a project internationally, international project, then we have triangle of project. In this triangle, always we have a scope or framework. Also we have schedule, which is time and priority, and here we have resources, which is about HR, finance, and fixed assets. In the middle of this model, we have quality. And then, because this is international, this is in intercultural situation. Then, this project can get different influences. First of all, we talk about risks. Different risks can influence this project. As we know, we have four categories for risk: governmental risk, and we manage them, governmental risk management; financial risk, and we manage them, financial risk management; project risk, and we manage them, project risk management; and enterprise risk, and we manage them, enterprise risk management. For each one, we have some factors to understand them and identify them. Okay, we talk about, first of all, governmental risk. All risks like viruses, technology of punishment, everything comes from the government, like regulation, law, huh? Law, regulation. And financial risk, they have also four different categories. First one is, I can use another color. First one is market risk. Second one is credit risk. Next one is liquidity. And the last one is operational risk. And this is the way to recognize the financial risk. When we talk about project risk, then we have nine different aspects. Project risk. I can write about them. According to the triangle of project, we have a scope risk, we have HR risk, we have cost estimation risk, time estimation risk, risk of communication, we have risk of integration, we have risk of quality, or we can call it standard. We have also risk of resources. And we call it, for example, logistic and procurement. These are the project risks. And then the last one is enterprise risk. When we talk about enterprise risk, we have risk of three factors: risk of leadership, strategy, and the decision, or wrong decision, or right decision. These are the risk of enterprises. It's the head of, in the head of company, like board of managers or leadership. This can influence our project. And then we already learned how to calculate this risk. We can do like this. We say risk is probability of each factor times impact of each factor. And if you want to go to the real answer, also ratio of factor after normalization. And then this is the model to calculate this risk. But in another side, culture also can influence our risk, or sorry, in our project. Then we have two categories for this. We say visible culture, we can see that. If we can make an iceberg, is 30% visible. And we have invisible culture, which is more than 70% of culture here. That's why we call it iceberg of culture. And also, we have another category for that. We say we have also Western culture and non-West culture. And this is also can influence our project. But in the middle, we have also some countries, we call them torn countries, like Turkey, Russia, and Mexico. They are traditional, they are non-West, but they try to be West. That's why we call them torn countries. And then, according to Professor Hoestede, six dimensions can influence for cultural factors, cultural differences can influence for project internationally. Number one is individualism and collectivism. Number two is power distance. Number three, uncertainty avoidance. Number four, long-term and short-term orientation. Number five, masculinity and femininity. And number six, indulgence and restraint. Then, with all these factors, we can manage our project very good. We can find how. In all these factors, we need to also think about some other factors, how they can be important for our project. We call them, one is market. What is our market target? And one is about consumer. And one is about marketing. For our market target, we need to find our market. How to do that? We have a topic for this called market intelligence. And for consumer, we have also a topic called consumer behavior, to forecast the behavior of consumer. And then we do advertisement to sell our products or services, which is the result of our project. Because you already know, each project has one result, product or service. And this is an overview of project with all factors that can influence this project internationally. Thank you so much.